And check out the view from the CTV Skywatch camera looking downtown towards the post office there. And weather's clearing a little bit just in time for the YWCA Women of Distinction event tonight at the Lethbridge Lodge. Sarah Ames, Vicki Miller, Birga Moen, Mary Runt, and Edith Stewart are all going to be honored tonight. I love this event. It is just a real uplifting celebration of women in the community. So if you got your tickets, hope to see you there tonight. -3 degrees is where we're at right now. We have misty conditions out there as the system is trying to exit our province, and it's going to increase in intensity as it enters Saskatchewan. It's already picking up an extra push of precipitation as it crosses the border into Saskatchewan. Regina and Saskatoon already bracing for some snowfall tonight. In our province, though, we're looking at things clearing out. And as I said to Jackie, you know, there's that chance of leftover flurries tonight and again tomorrow. But you can see it very, very clearly defined here. You can see the core of that system starting to push into Saskatchewan. And this is, you know, just going to speed up as it does so and intensifies. It picks up an extra boost of precipitation coming up from the United States. So they're in for some snow tonight. We on the other side are looking at clearing skies eventually moving in. As we get into the middle of next week, we'll be looking at teen temperatures and lots of sunshine. So focus ahead into next week. Right now, we're just seeing some splotches of precipitation making their way across. Forecasters showing earlier on the amount of precipitation that we had making its way through, but we will be seeing all these amounts really start to break up and dissipate as this whole core of the system moves eastward and pushes off. Area of high pressure is trying to dig in behind it, but just the upslope condition that we're in yet tomorrow will get into an easterly flow, and that gives us a chance of seeing some leftover instability and a chance of some flurry activity, but nothing to worry about, nothing like what we had today. Down east, we've got blowing snow in parts of Newfoundland, Labrador, cooling temperatures through the Maritimes, but they did see a lot of sunshine there today, and the temperatures continue to cool as the cold front makes its way through. Ottawa and Toronto looking at a couple of rainy days ahead. Big change for Toronto. Yesterday, they had an all-time record high of 26 degrees. They were quite a bit cooler than that today. Still holding on to 15 degrees in Winnipeg right now. Cloudy skies there, some fog developing. 4 degrees in Regina, -5 in Saskatoon, and they are preparing for that snowfall tonight. Some sunshine and some cloud on the BC coast, and a couple of sunny days ahead for both Whitehorse and Yellowknife. They're looking at some, well, three or four days for Yellowknife for sunshine over the next little while, so a nice break for them. East Kootenay, you're looking at showers tonight with a chance of flurries, -1 for a low. Sun and cloud mixed tomorrow, 8 degrees for a high, and not too windy in your forecast area tomorrow as well. That's a bonus. Crow's Nest Pass, chance of flurries tonight, -8 degrees, -2 for a high tomorrow. Cloudy with a chance of flurries tomorrow as well. Your winds will be out of the northeast at about 20 kilometers per hour. Medicine Hat, looking at that light snow ending and then a chance of flurry activity overnight, -4 for a low, and then cloudy tomorrow with a chance of a leftover flurry, 0 for a daytime high. And here in Lethbridge, we're looking at that chance of flurries happening tonight, very scattered, -7 for a low, and then tomorrow we're into that upslope, so elevated humidity, chance of a leftover flurry, but certainly cloudy skies tomorrow. As we get into Sunday, we've got cloudy skies, 6 degrees. Monday is the day we have a sun and cloud mix, but there is that chance of some rain showers happening as well. Might be a little cloudier than what this graphic indicates here. Tuesday and Wednesday, we start to really pull out nicely as far as temperatures go, get back to well above average, which is 8 degrees at this time of the year for the Lethbridge area. Congratulations to Mark. Mark has worked with disabled children for a lot of years, and he's done that in three provinces right across Western Canada through Manitoba, Saskatchewan, and Alberta. So a lot of years put in, and we have a basket here for you. Congratulations, Mark. We appreciate your volunteer spirit. That's it for me. Have a safe weekend, everyone.